Well, just one question to the extent that consistency would have it that if you confront Muslim communities with basic ideas of religious pluralism or the separation of state and church, that the society that is confronting Muslims communities with these principles should confront those principles itself. So what we've seen now, for example, is the European Court saying to Italy, you should remove the crucifixes from the classrooms in the public school. Or, to go even one step further, one could say that in Denmark or in Britain, where you have a state church, shouldn't we reflect upon what sort of secularization of public institutions we need to accommodate Islam and remain truthful to principles of religious and philosophical pluralism? Do you think the European Court is right, for example, or that Denmark could go on having a state church and still confronting the Muslim communities in Denmark with a separate state and church?
I don't think that the former organizations in the United Kingdom or Denmark, which are of an archaic type, that they matter so much. I mean, there is a formal state religion, but as far as I understand, in practice, there is not much difference from other countries. Maybe I am wrong, I am not that familiar. Formally, I mean, it should be abolished, but if it doesn't matter, I mean, there are so many things that found in England only symbolically that I wouldn't mind, yeah? But I mean, if it comes to the conflicts you mentioned, then the constitutional principles of a secular state that separates church from the state should be applied consistently. And the German thought has ruled a similar question in such a way, when I remember correctly, if there is one parent in a class asking for removing religious symbols, it has to be done. So that's a more slightly modern ruling. Nevertheless, I mean, it aroused a very interesting debate. The Catholics, if I remember correctly, argued that these symbols, of course, are cultural symbols. And I do not think that this goes through on legal terms. On legal terms, that doesn't go through. I mean, what does it matter? I mean, the Protestants, by the way, insisted that religious symbols are religious ones. That this is not an argument. So, I mean, you saw a nice confessional split in this discussion. The first thing is, the state must insist on implementing constitutional principles. That means, for all religious communities, in practice, to acknowledge religious tolerance, living together peacefully with the other religions and the non-believers. Secondly, recognition of the institutionalized science, authority of science. And finally, the recognition of, let me put it loosely, the morality of human rights. That means the moral infrastructure of the constitutional state. That must be ours. But we shouldn't stay and then say, this is of our Christian tradition, by the way it was done. I mean, it was only partly so. I mean, the formal recognition of all that was done in Vatican II and in Eastern Germany and the Protestant churches were by no means earlier in their recognition of liberal principles. So, I mean, on the other hand, I would say that the secularists among us, not only the secular person, I am a secular person, but the secularists are the more militant and nervous people who prefer a narcissist schedule. I mean, they should recognize that secularization of state power is not identical with the secularization of society. And it was always a touch of paradox in our liberal constitutions that there were two elements, namely the empowerment of religious citizens to lead a pious life and not to separate this life from their civic life. That is an element of our basic rights. And on the other hand, we have to care for the fact that all political decisions that can be implemented with state power, sanctions, political decisions, must be not only formulated, but must be able to be justified in a language that is publicly accessible for anyone. So that there can be any religious language in it. So I am arguing for religious voices in the democratic process, within the public sphere, and within civil society. But then there must be a filter once it comes to political institutions, to those bodies who are authorized to make decisions binding for everybody and sanctions by state.